So we've seen that functions are extremely important in JavaScript, and they create the core of JavaScript classes. As you described earlier, a JavaScript class is really just a function that's capable of creating many similar objects.
Exactly. Anytime a function produces objects that all conform to roughly the same interface of methods and properties, I would call that function a class. But it is important to know that this definition draws some controversy, because there are good arguments out there that classes really shouldn't be boiled down so simply. In other languages, this is certainly the case, but in JavaScript at least, I think that this definition provides us the most value. So, if we do broaden our definition of the word class to mean any construct that's capable of producing a fleet of very similar objects, we should really examine every technique we can think of that would satisfy writing such a class. We'll do this by starting with our decorator code that we just wrote and refactoring it into the functional class pattern. And from there, we'll move on to the prototypal and pseudo-classical patterns. And along the way, we can talk about the pros and cons of each technique.